Okay, hello, good afternoon again. Okay, so for today, we'll be talking about influence line. So, influence line po, wait lang ha. Nababati man it akong boses. Okay. So, influence line, gagamit inihiya pag visualize kunhain diin nga fortunate beam magkakamay ada in maximum shear or moment due to moving load. Diba? Sometimes kasi, for example, may na kasi kita mga structures nga subjected to moving load. A very good example of this is the bridge. Okay? So, a very good example of this is the bridge. So, kumbaga, if we want to determine the kunhain diin nga portion it load nga ibubutang it pinaka-critical gamit at ginagamit influence line gigagamit ini pag visualize kunhain diin nga portion hand beam ibubutang ang load nga magkakamay ada kitahin maximum shear or moment. So duha ini nga klase atang influence line. Mayra kita influence line for shear, mayra kita influence line for moment, pwede man kita gihap influence line for load. Pero never mind that. And atong ipo-focus on the influence line shear for shear and the influence line for the moment. Okay. Dili kita hit ko and let us have an example. Okay, so suppose we have this simply supported beam. The left support is, say for example, this is A and the right support is B. Okay. So, for example, if this beam is subjected to a moving load. Ano ba ito moving load? Parang meron dito pwede vehicle or whatsoever. Basta nag-move, meron dito. Say, for example, this P. Tapos, ini naman nga P, nag-move ito niya tipa ka. Di. Okay, nag-move ito niya. So, itas natin. Maghimo ko itong diagram, karani influence line, para ma-visualize natin kung, for example, if the section in, ang atong i-consider nga section is, for example, this section, say, let's name this point C. Okay. Hain ba diin dapat ang P, ang load, di natin ibubutang ang P para magkakamiada kitahin maximum shear or moment at point C. Parang sugitan. So, may da ni mo, to, in solving for the, in constructing the influence line, may da kayo to point nga ginko consider, may da kayo point nga ginko consider, tapos gin-visualize ni mo, gin-kikita ni mo kung hain diin nga portion hand load and magkakamayada yung maximum shear due to a moving load. Maximum shear at C due to a moving load. Okay, let us have an example. Suppose, wait lang ha. Let me erase. Okay, let me erase this one. Pwede man nga yun, kung ano. Ctrl-Z. So, say for example, L, the span of the beam, say for example, 5. Okay. And we want to construct the influence line at point C. Point C, it is in mid-span between A and B. So, ada in between A and B. Ada mid-span, for example. Huh? We want to construct the influence line due to shear. Due to shear. Okay, so paano man? Nasukod na yun niya. Unit load. So, unit load, ibig sabihin, magnitude is 1, kay unit load. Okay, so, suppose, an unit load, imula na ikakadalida ha, point A. Diba? Let's say, 1. Sige, for example, 1. Kay unit load man lang. Okay, tas kukuha ni mo an iya mga reaction. So kung ada an load, an reaction DD is 1, tas an reaction DD is 0. Do you agree? Oh, you have to agree because that's correct. Okay. And sunod naman, an 1, oh. Okay? Paparaon ni mo an, okay, wait lang. So if this is the case, magpapaskahin kating plane ni daha point C, tas kukuhaon ni mo ang shear niya. Okay? Magpapaskahin kating plane ni daha point C, tas kukuhaon ni mo ang shear niya. So, masing ka din eh. This is the... Oops, hindi kita pabutang. This is the portion of the beam, and this is the cutting plane. Dila ka nagkata point C, tas meron mo dila shear. Tapos, lididian mo... 1, tas meron nyo dito 1 gihap an applied load, tas this is the reaction. And this distance is x. So, an imo shear, your shear will be 0. So, ibig sabihin, an imo shear ha point C, when the unit load is at point A, okay ha? Let me reiterate again, let me say it again. An imo shear ha point C, when your load is at point A, is 0. Adi, nasolve na ton. Ha? Okay. 0, ha? And when your load is at point A. Okay. Now, mag-create ka na naman in another scenario. Diba? Kaya mag-create kita in another scenario because the load is moving. Take note, ha? The load is moving. Okay. So, suppose, yeah, atong point in... Okay, consider is this point, and this is point C, this is A, B, C. Tapos, and ano naman nga load, imumove natin nga dililiha point C. Still unit load lang nga how. If that's the case, ang imo DD, ang imo reaction is 0.5. Tapos, ang imo DD, this is 0.5 also. So, 0.5 and 0.5. Tapos, magpapasa yung cutting plane naman dila. Pasa yung cutting plane. Consider niyo ang nga left. So, this is your portion of the beam, and this is your cutting plane. Okay? So, meron niyo di 0.5. Meron niyo 0.5, ha? Tapos, meron niyo di ang load niyo. Ito para pala di daan. Pero ito, 1. 1 ang magnitude. Tapos, isosolve niyo ang shear. So, using the summation of forces along y-axis, makukuha ni mo nga an imo shear ha, is equal to, just to be sure, let's use the summation of forces, the vertical forces is 0, taking upward forces as the positive force. So, we have your 0.5, this is shear, minus 1, minus the V, or the shear, is equal to 0. So, ang imo V is equal to, pera ba? Negative ba? Ah, okay. Wait lang. Mali. Ayun, wait lang, ha? Let me explain it again. Okay. Let me explain how we do it here. Okay. Di ba magpapas kita yung cutting plane din yung point C? Okay. If the cutting plane is just to the left of C, okay, yeah, the word there, just to the left of C. So, ibig sabihin, and one nga, what's this? And one nga unit load will not be included because ang cutting plane, ang cutting section will be passing through point C, just to the left of C. So, parang masugad din eh, masugad. This is the portion of the beam, and this is the cutting plane. Hindi niya 0.5, tas adi din niya mo shear. So, if the cutting plane is just to the left of C, this is the shear, your shear is equal to 0.5. Okay? Yan. Okay, 0.5. And, if your cutting plane is just to the right, of C, para masugad, this is the cutting plane. Tapos, ano din yan yung 0.5. Tapos, ano din yan yung imo unit load. Tapos adyan imo shear. Okay. Imo shear will be negative 0.5. Yan. So, just to the left of C is, the shear is positive 0.5. And just to the right of C is negative 0.5. And that is the case if the load, ha? If the load is at point C. Okay. Balik kita nga dito. Ang ina, ha? The shear at point C, the shear at point C is 0 when the load is at point A. Okay? The shear at point C is 0 when the load is at point A. Now, dito naman, the shear is 0.5 at point C. Ha? The shear is 0.5 at point C if the load, if the unit load is on point C. Okay? Now, let us have another scenario. What will happen if the unit load, okay, ha? What will happen if the unit load is aadidili ang point B? Aradida. Kaya rin, point C natin, and point in question. Okay, so, if this is the case, okay, so, ang imo reaction, didi may dani mo 1, tapos didi 0. So, when you pass a cutting plane at point C, yan ha, we are considering, ano, to the left. So, this is your cutting plane, and this is the portion of the beam. May daning mo din ni 1, the reaction, that's an applied load, an unit load you have. So, an imo shear, your shear is also equal to 0. Okay? Review kita review. Okay, ha? An atong point nga gingo consider is point C. So, we are actually visualizing the it position it load nga kundiin magkakamay ada yung maximum shear and point C. Okay, anyhow. At kuan, at point C, the shear is 0 when the load, when the unit load is at point A. Di ha? Adap man. Shear is 0 at point C. Now, shear is 0.5 or negative 0.5 just to the, just to the left of C. And negative naman is just to the right of C. So, the value is 0.5 if the load is at point C. Kung adap mismo at point C. Tapos naman, ang shear at point C is 0 when the load is at point B. So, what this tells you, nayakan, maximum each shear, di ba kita 0, 0, maximum each shear if at point C, maximum each shear at point C if the load is ada mismuhan point C. Okay, so kung atan dito drawing, ankoan, let me put it here, so ganda. Kung atan dito drawing and atan an iya influence line, naso ba dito? Okay, ha? This is the beam. This is point A, point B, ada dito it point C. So naso ba dito ni iya influence line, naso ba? Yeah. This is 0.5 and this is 0.5. Yeah, this is the influence line of the this is the influence line, the shear influence line for the beam at point C, okay? The shear influence line for the beam at point C, specifically at point C. So, this diagram here tells you that if the load panangitan na diyan actual beam. Panahulitan natin ang actual beam, ano? This diagram tells you, if the load is at point A, adi nga DDO, zero it iya shear, P. Ha? Panahulitan P. If your P is, panahulitan, let's use another color. If your P is ADDD, maximum kay ano? And, okay. Imo kasi, if you have the influence line kasi, madali mo nalang masusolve ikuan. Madali mo nalang masusolve it shear. For example, ha? Let us have an example. Before kita kuan. Panaglitan. Adididi. pananglitan an imo valuehan moving load and load nga nagbo-move is pananglitan 10 say for example newton 10 newton masugod ka iton it imo shear is equal to 10 newton multiplied for whatever is this distance ini nga distance so kun ada pero an hino yung undan ano ba tawag iton ang hino yung dan, tinutunguran han load. So, indin hi. Takay zero man itong dila nga distance. So, times zero. So, your shear is equal to zero. So, pananglitan ko ng imo load, DDD, pananglitan, si for example, 10 newton. What ito yung multiply? Ini nga distance. O, di ba? Ang imo shear is equal to 10 newton multiplied by 0.5. And that is 5 newton. Ibig sabihin, okay, delete ko an, delete ko lang eh, ha? Wait lang. Let us discuss the different types of problem nga nagkakaguwas it sugod hini nga kuan, hini nga problem. Sugod it question it problem. Ay, sorry. It mga line of questioning hindi ni nasugod it mga line of questioning. May da daw load. May da load daw nga nagmo-move nga naagi. Si for example, the load is for example lang ha. The load is a truck. Truck ano? Trakya o an truck nga ni, nasugod man ito ni truck. Oh, ay kati truck. Kuha nala. four-wheeler. Basta, car. Di ba nasugod it car? Ay, di ba kinikita. Nasugod it car. Sugod. Tas, uy, pasensya na kamutak car ha. Adililiit wheels. Oh, di ba? Nagta-traverse nga niini nga car, dahil bridge. It load nga natatransfer ito nga to it bridge. Ada dida. Siyempre, ada it wheel. Di ba? Ada dida. So, kung nagtatraverse nga dito nga dida, duduha ito nga nga load. So, for example, unload, nasugad unload. Pananglitan lang ha. Unload, nasugad. For the sake of kuan lang, say for example, this is 5 newton, ngayon 5 newton. Tapos, ang distance naman nera is, say for example, 1 meter. Kay gutay man lang a car. Toy car man lang. Oo. Kaya i-delete ko yun eh. Delete ko lang yun. Wait lang. I-delete ko lang ang car ng tsaka. Okay. So, for example, amin eh. Anong car nga nagtatraverse, didaan aton beam. Okay? It usual nga pakiana, ano nga position, or acting, pama, it pakiana, it usual nga pakiana is, what is the maximum shear at point C when the car, ini nga load, a moving load, is traversing this beam. Okay? Again, what is the maximum shear at point C, take note, and atong point C, ang hiling yan point C natin, or it means span. This is our point C. What is the maximum shear at point C when this load right here traverses this kuan? This beam. Okay. Makita ka na dilit imo kuan. Of course, makita ka dilit imo tawag ini influence diagram. Okay. Kasi kung wala niyo influence diagram, damit ma-answer, I'm sure, damit ma-answer. Siyempre, mas dako i-share kung a-adhit boot nga i-car, di ba? But, according to the influence line, kita adaw niyo, according to the influence line, imo nga i-boot nga, so ibig sabihin, a-adhit dyan o sa nga load, so, the distance dito is 0.5, this is 0.5, this is 5 newton, this is 5 newton, ibig sabihin, ang isang load, ADDD, han positive shear. Tapos, ang isang load, ADDD, han, oops, this is negative pala. ADDD, han negative shear. So, ibig sabihin, kung ikada mo nga nitbot nga it car, magbabalance out la itong hiya. because anong sa positive, anong sa negative. And by the way, kung ang gimpapabilin is the maximum share, it does not matter kung positive or negative. Ang imula, bibil mo talaga ang pinakadako ng numerical value. So for example, if you are comparing negative 10 kilonewton and positive 5 kilonewton, pinakadako ito nila ang negative 10 kilonewton na share. Okay? Sabuhi lang ito. Okay, so to answer the question kung ano ang maximum shear, you have to see to it nga dapat ang ininga load kay ininga ni kasi nga position, di ba, magbabalance out kasi adyo-adyo mo sa positive tas ano sa naman adyo negative. So kung if that's the case, masugad ka. Kailangan mo pa inbilingon ininga distance nga ininga distance. Diba kay anong kasi ang iya tinutungudan. Okay, let's find this distance. Masayin man lang ito kay ratio and proportion man la. O, adihin da ako nga triangle. Tapos adihin guti nga triangle. O, masugad ka. 0.5 is to pero ba yung nga distance? What's the span? 5. 5 is the span. So this is 2.5. This distance is 2.5. So 0.5 is to 2.5 is equal to, let's name that distance as y because it's along the y-axis. Y over, pero manin nga distance, tikan din nga di. That distance is 2.5 minus 0.5. Yan. Diba? 2.5 minus 0.5. And that is 2, so your y is equal to, let me get my calculator. Wait lang. Nakalimutan ko na akong calculator. Let me get my calculator. Hello, Ma. Good
afternoon. Ma. Oh, yes, Ma. Tapos ang palamutan klase mo ba? Isang kuhain mo ba?
Wait lang, ha. Kuha ko lang calculator. Yan, nakikita na ba ito calculator? Okay, so I have here the calculator. So we are solving for the value of y. This is 0.5 over 2.5 is equal to y over 2.5 minus 0.5. And we are solving for y. Okay, solving for y, the answer is 0.4. So, ibig sabihin na natin y is, this is 0.4. O, adigi hap, 0.4 yun, kaya parang malayit era distance, di ba? Symmetric man lang era. So, an aim of shear at C, if this is the case, ha, if this is the case, an aim of shear is equal to 5, the magnitude of demand, 5 newton, multiplied by, and y nu is 0.4, plus, ano sa nga 5 newton multiplied by, and di kay negative man ini, adi man niya, pero same lang ako, 0.4. This is negative 0.4. And imo VC is 0. So you can see, nga, kung an imo nga ni car, an imo load, is adahan but nga, for this case lang ha, for this case, an imo maximum, an imo shear, kung adahan but nga, an imo share will be 0. Okay? Diba? Makita ninyo, 0. So, it pinaka the best way. You would think of a situation, dapat magbibiling kahin situation kung saan ining duduha nga share is dapat din na nagbabalance out. Kung positive, positive la. Kung negative, negative la. Diba? Nakuha? O, hain man ito. Let me erase this again. Pan-erase ko ini. Wait lang. Pan-erase ko lang ini. Oh, wala man tapag erase. Sorry. Inigihap i-erase ko. Yan. So the question then would be, ikakain may naton, hain ba ini nga kuan it magkakamay ada ni maximum share. Masugod kita adaw kun adi dili. Kun adi dili imo kuan it imo 5 newton. Tas adi naman sa 5 newton. And the distance, take note how the distance between them is 1 meter. O ada, sugod dito, it magkakamay ada kita ni maximum shear. Or pwede gihap, ibalhin natin ini. Kaya maximum because both of this function relate positive nga kuha nit influence line. Okay, or pwede gihap natin ini ibalhin pananglitan. Ibalhin natin nga di ano? Ano dida? Sugad. Oops. Yan. Or sugaditon. Now this time, pwede gihap because adihira nga duha negative. Nakuha? Adihira nga duha negative. So, dihira magbabalance. Kumbaga, mag-negative na sa negative nga duha. Anyway, it negative and positive, it does not affect the kuan kung height mas makusog, nga positive, it mas makusog kay positive. It only tells you the direction. It positive and negative. So if this is the case, ini, okay, ani din hi, gamitan tanya ni, adi di liya nagpapas, so tas anong sanaman ini, adi di liya, okay, ini mo aram nakita, this is negative 0.5, and adi di kita mo aram, let's name it y first, then we have to solve for that, so we have a 0.5, negative 0.5, or never mind the negative, kay kuan malito niya. Direction. Is to 2.5 is equal to y is to 2.5 minus 1. Kaya ano? This distance kasi is 2.5 and this distance is 1. Diba? 1 man this is 2.5 man. So, ini nga distance din hi is 2.5 minus 1. That's why dili 2.5 minus 1. Well, let me erase this. Okay, so solving for the value of y, your y is equal to, let me get my calculator. This is 2.5 minus 1. So solving for the value of y, your y is equal to 0.3. So this is 0.3. Negative, ha? Negative ka. Adi ha ubos. Okay, so your shear then at point C will be equal to, of course, the magnitude of the force, 5 newton multiplied by, adi anak ko consider lanay, multiplied by this distance. Negative 0.5. Plus, of course, the 5 newton multiplied by, ini naman nga distance, that is 0.3. Negative 0.3. And BC is equal to, pero ba yun? 0.5 is 2.5. Calculator na daw na. 0.5 times 5 plus 5 times 0.3. So, 4. So, this is 4 newton. This is the shear at point C. This is the maximum shear at point C, excuse me ha, when a moving load traverses this beam. Okay, this is your answer. O kung panangalitan, ibahon tayo question. Kung panangalitan yung question na sa ring. Ano ba ito mga kuhan? Find the maximum shear at point C. Sometimes kasi it na nagtatraverse gihap, there yung mga concentrated load. Ini kasi mga concentrated load kasi. Sometimes it nagtatraverse is uniformly distributed load. Okay, naghatag yung uniformly distributed load, W. Let's use another color. Green. Sometimes it nagtatraverse is uniformly distributed load. Say for example, the magnitude of that uniformly distributed load is 2 newton per meter. Pananglitan. So, ganito. Tapos waray nag-indicate kung gano'ng kahilaba ang load. Diba? Kuhan kasi niya. Uniformly distributed load. Nasugad man ito niya. Uniformly distributed load. Diba? Usually, uniformly distributed load, medyo ito niya definite nga kuhan, nga distance. Kung wala nga nag-indicate, ibig sabihin, ikaw gimpapakuan, gimpapabuot. Kung wala nag-indicate. Okay, so the question would be, find the maximum shear at point C when a uniformly distributed load traverses the beam. Okay, ini. Paano naman itong sugad iton kung uniformly distributed load naman? Okay, let me erase this again. Let me erase this. And this also. Hello. Wait lang ha, erase ko lang.
Okay.
Pero tapos ko na pa.
Pwede on that.
Yan. Okay. So for example, ini unload. Tapos yung papabiling an maximum shear at point C. Dali man kita marang kung pera ang distance niya, ano? Okay, kitaon mo it kuhan. Kitaon mo it the influence line. Kitaon mo. Kain ba diin? Kasi kung imo nga ni ikuhan, imo nga ni tanan. Because someone might think nga, syempre, maximum it share kung tanan o throughout the kuhan, butangan niyo yung load. Diba? But when you look at the influence line, and yun nga, ang katungahan moving ang load, yung nga dididi, ang katungahan, yung nga dididi, so magbabalance out here. Okay, so that's not a good idea. So paano man ikukuhan it, it moving load, din mo man ibubutang para magkakamayada kay maximum shear. Siyempre, di na let half. Diba? Half. Or pwede didihan usang half. Basta, ano usa lang half. Because looking at the kuhan, kuan man kasi symmetrical man an aton given. Di ba? Symmetrical. So, kada mo dida. And this is 2 newton per meter. How to solve for the shear? Shear is equal to, of course, the 2 newton per meter multiplied by an area gihapan yan. Okay? Nakuha? Kung uniformly distributed load, a day, and magnitude multiplied by the area of the diagram. Okay, and the area of the diagram is triangle, that is 1/2 base times height. The base is 0.5. No. The base is 2.5 pala. 2.5, and the height, this is the base, this is 2.5, and the height is 0.5. So, Ano ito na? So your shear will be, this will cancel out, 2.5 times 0.5, that is 1.25. Let me check. 2.5 times 0.5 is 1.25, right?
Sige na, balita. Ayaw na itong picture.
1.25, this is in Newton. Oh, because ang baseline meter, tas adi, unitless man. So this is just shear. This is the maximum shear when a load of 2 newton per meter traverses the ano, the, yun. Ini ba nga kuan, ini nga beam. Okay. Pero kung for example, naghatagin kuan, length and hand kuan, naghatagin length and ano, and load. For example, ang ginhatag is 5 meters. 5 meters. Diin mo man ibubutang. Ah, sige daw, this is a very good koan. A very good question. Sige daw. Somebody comment down below. Charo. How about if the uniform distributed load, the magnitude is 2 newton per meter, pero gintagan gihap kitahin length and uniform distributed load. Where do you think di inaton, di ba ang length gihapan unit, ang length gihapan aton kuan, ang aton beam is 5 meters, the spine of the beam is also 5 meters. So di man aton ibubutang, di in kaya, charot. Wait lang ha. Okay. So if this is the case, okay, one might think nga ikakarat natin da ano. Bangin may da magyakan nga ikakarat natin all throughout the beam ibubutang. No, that's not the case. Kasi for influence line, for influence line, pwede ka magbutang masugad itin magbutang. Kumbaga, and kato nga, han imo length and uniform distributed load is ato ang guwasan beam. Pwede ito, ha? So, same lang nga how it case, dapat, kung maximum man imo gimbibiling, and imo load nga aadalahan beam, dapat kutob ladidahan ang katunga lahan beam. If this is the case, syempre, na-depende gihapit ko an hit type of beam. Okay? Na-depende gihapit type of beam. Okay. So that's the kuan. That's how you draw the uniform the influence line for the beam. Again ha, nasugan. Let's just have a recap. Okay? Nag-try kita. Siyempre, imo lang i-identify kung haing nga point and imo gin ko consider. For example, masaring draw the influence line for the shear at point C or the shear at point 2 meters from the left support. Yung na-identify lang ay kung haing nga point and atong gin ko consider. Before kita mag-biling kung mag-construct an influence line. And after that, mag-assume ka. And imo kada an unit load ha, unit load lang, excuse me, unit load lang ha. I-assume ni mo an unit load nga adhan left support first, tapos kukuha, i-solve ni mo an shear dito han point nga ginko consider. At this case point C. So for example din ni, when the unit load is at point A, the shear at point C is 0. Tapos ginbali naman naton an load nga diha point C. And if that's the case, the load at point C is the shear at point C is 0.5 or negative 0.5. Okay? Tapos kung nagkali natin habi, the shear at point C is 0. Tapos i-construct na rin, magkukunik-kunik lang mo. Okay? Let's have another example. But this time, we will not use that technique. May da kasi usap pa nga technique para madali it ko ang pagbibiling hit influence line. Okay? So for example, may nakita sa ganyan yun. Yan, so say for example, adding a point na natin bibiling. And this is 2 meters from the left support. And say for example, this is 3 meters from the right support. Let's name this A, B, and this is point C. Okay. So, paano man natin mabibilingan? Influence line. Asahin lang ito. Shear nga ni kasi, mag-share off nga ni kasi ito kuan, it usa nga beam. Parang, for example, if this is the kuan, if this is the beam, diba? For example lang ha. Mag-share off nga ni itong hiya. Parang nakakuha itong hiya na sugad. nasugad ito niya. Paano ba? If this is the beam, mag-share of money, nasugad. Diba? Sugot, bibit ko. Diba? Continuous and beam, mautod nga nila, mag-share of money, masugad ito. Masugad ito. Okay? So, kumbaga, mautod and beam, ano usa nga, ano sa mapababa, ano sa mapailarom. Parang ganon. Diba yan? So, kumbaga, mauuto dito ng dida, it's alright, be masugad. Oops. Para masugad. Ano sa maubos? Ah, oh, sorry. Ano sa mabaw-baw? Oops. Tapos ano sa maubos? Para masugad ba? Masugad. Okay. Tapos, diri kita maaram kung pera ini nga distance. Diri kita maaram kung pera ini nga distance. Pero, maaram kita kung pera ini nga distance. The whole, maaram kita. Oh, Balik kita nga di. Anya ni nga distance? Ini nga distance is 0.5. Ano nga distance is 0.5 also. Nag-negative lang heavy cost below here. Take note ha, ito nga negative, it only indicates the direction. Okay? And if you add, ini nga distance nga DDD, that is 1. And this is true, bisan hano nga klase hing beam. Okay? Pero may itong niya 1. Kay 1 lang, di ba? 1 malang unit load. Unit load malang natin din kukuan. Yung consider. So, that is 1. Ini nga distance, that is 1. Okay? So, paano man? Oops. Let me erase this. Yan. Okay. So, dito mo kita maaram ano kung pera yung nga distance. Let's name it X. O ini, dito mo kita maaram. Pwede natin maranan itong hiyahin another letter, A. O, ay kita pag X nga yan. Kay along the Y man inihiya. O, X nala, sige. Pwede natin gamitin hindi ni nga A. Pero, we have to see to it that we are only using only one variable, only one unknown. So, we can express A in terms of X and that is 1 minus X. Diba? Kasi ini nga distance kasi maramang kita nga 1. Tapos hindi dinugta ito ini nga distance as x. O di, ano sa 1 minus x. Ganun. Okay. Tapos maram naman kita ini nga distance. Ini nga mga distances. Adi man, this is 2, this is 3. Ito habaw ba, diba? Adi man, 2 ngayon 3. So, ano na. Tsaka tak drawing. I-redraw ko lang ha. Wait lang. I-redraw ko lang. Ano ba yun? Bow. This is A, this is B, and this is C. This is X, and this is 1 minus X. Okay. Tapos usapan natin nga matitigam na, is this, in its slope hini, oh, audit me though. Ay, sorry. Sorry.
Baka gwapo talaga.
Maka arawad man. Dili nga yung kinikita, ma'am. Nakada ngayon, habon nga na ako nawong. Sorry. Artista lang. Sorry. Sorry.
Ngayon ito nagbalin.
Walo, ano pa talaga takpon yun. Sige na lang. Okay, so another thing that we can use into our advantage, charot. Okay, it's slope fini, ngayon slope fini magpareho. So technically, this triangle, and this triangle are similar. They are similar. So kung similar, we can use the ratio and proportion or the similar triangle. Ratio and proportion, di ba? So, this will be Adila lang nga triangle magot yan. So this is x is to 2. Diba? This distance kasi is 2. X is to 2. Tapos 1 minus x is to 3. This is 1 minus x is to 3. So solving for the value of x, that is using the calculator. This is 1 minus x is to 3. So this is 0.4. So your x is 0.4. So an imo 1 minus x is 0.6. Diba? 0.4 and 0.6. So babalikan ko nalang dayon para dire kita damuit ko. So an imo x is 0.4. An imo 1 minus x is 0.6. Yan. Wala na. Okay. Tapos, o pananglitan. Gimpapabiling an maximum shear. Unit load lang, point load lang. May nakita, say for example, 10 newton na nagtatraverse din. Diin mo man ibubutang i 10 newton para magkamaedakin maximum shear at point C. Okay, taon niyo mo, 0.6 dd. Natural, dida mismo it point C. Dida niyo mo ibubutang. So, dida niyo mo ibubutang. And that is 10 newton. So, an imo shear at point C will be, of course, the magnitude of the force multiplied by, i-multiply and 0.4 and 0.6 and i-multiply. This is negative. Negative 0.6. This is, unit less ito niya. So, an imo shear, an imo maximum shear is 6. 6, yes. 6 newton. I don't know. I'm waiting with imo maximum shear at point C. 4.C if you have a moving load with a magnitude of 10 newton. Yan. How about, kung may dakita, pananglitan sugad. Tapos may dati, newton, tapos may dati di, say 5 newton. Tapos the distance between them is, say for example, 1 meter. O din mo ibubutang. Again ha, you have to be very mindful, it dapat diri nagbabalance out. Kasi kun imong nga ibutang dida, it usa didi, tapos ito sa naman didi, magbabalance out itong hiya. Instead nyo mag-maximum. Di rin na mag-maximum kaya ginbabalance out man. Pero dapat on one side of the coin ka. Pero na-depende, gihap. Dapat kasi ginkikita mo. Di na natin matitest. It koan. It analytical ability student. Charot. di natin ibubutang. Hindi natin ibubutang. Siyempre, didi. Kaya didi, mas dako. 0.6. This is 10 newton. Tapos ano sa naman didi? 5 newton. The distance between them is 1 meter. But we have a problem. Hindi kita maaram compare yung nga distance. Yung nga distance. Kailangan natin masolve yung distance. Let's name that y. And that y is... paano ba natin masusolve? Let me erase this one. Okay, paano ba masusolve it? Y. So, y is 2. What's this distance? That is 3. Kaya na, 3 man yung distance. 3. Minus ini 1. So, 2 is equal to 0.6 and is 2, 3. Pero man, using the calculator, this is 0.6 divided by 3 times 2, that is 0.4. So, ibig sabihin, your y is equal to 0.4, negative, because adi haubos. So, your answer, your maximum shear at point C, will be 10 newton multiplied by negative 0.6 plus 5 newton multiplied by negative 0.4. Yan. So your VC will be 10 times 0.6 plus 5 times 0.4. And that is negative 8 newton. This is the maximum shear. Okay? At point C. Kung amoy niya ang load na nag-traverse. Okay? Di ba masayang na? So that's how you solve. Okay, let's take this, let's take our example a little bit easier. Okay, suppose we have a beam like this. Tapos may adhesive and support. Pin. Hinge. Tama, hinge. Hinge. Kuan. Ruler. Tapos adhesive and pin. Natural, so nga natin yung beam, dapat pin hindi. Kaya ruler nga. Unstable. Okay, so this is a pin. Pin right here and ruler hindi. Okay, let's name this point A, point B, this is point C. Okay, tapos yung papabiling natin han, and say this is D. This is 2, 3 and 2. For example. Adi an atong yung papabiling ha. This is not pin ha. Parang yung kukun. Amuan atong yung bibiling. Yan daw. Wait lang. Let's use yellow. This is D. This is 2, 3 and so, ang ating bibiling is the maximum shear at point D if we have a moving load of dila na kita ko ang moving load natin is 10 newton. Okay, so diin man create ka lang ng influence line masayang man lang pag-create influence line hindi dila na kita pag-focus it din hilaan na, ilan na kita ilan natin i-consider yung itong overhang. Okay, ilan natin i-consider yung itong overhang dila na kita simply supported beam so, kumbaga masugad. Kumbaga, this is the, di ba, dida point D. At point D. Dida point D, kung dida rin yung bibiling, kumbaga, unshear, kumbaga, mautol dida, para masugod dito na yan. Dida rin mo yung straight line. Yan. Tapos masugod. Oops. Yan. Again, ha, dito kita maaramin yung distance. Dito kita maaramin yung distance. But together, we know era total distance is 1. Okay? Okay, tapos paano naman natin niya yung overhang? Masayang dito niya, extend line nga dito. Yan. Kaya kung malahiya, kumbaga, continuous malahiya. So, it is slope. It is yung dining portion, hindi magparegula dapat. Pati ang dining magparegula. Okay, so we will solve this distance first. This is x, and this is 1 minus x. So we have to solve this distance. Ini pati dili. Okay, totoo natin yung solve. Ini, nga ini. Solve for x first. Similar triangle there, ha? So this is x, adi. Is 2, pero yung distance. Adi, alia? Adi nga triangle na natin yung consider. This triangle. Okay? So that is x is 2, 3. And that is equal to 1 minus x is 2, 2. So your x, solving for the value of x, your x will be, let me use the calculator again, 3, 1, and minus x, 2. But this is 0.6. So in aton 1 minus x, this one, this is 0.4. 0.4, kahit saan ka sinira is 1 man. Okay. Iliwat ko dahil yung didi, ha? Iliwat ko dahil yung didi kaya para di rin ako magliwat later. So this is 0.6. Di naman, this is 0.4. O didi, paano naman yung didi? Let's name this x again. Let's just solve for this one. So this is x is 2. Adi nga triangle natin go consider. Pero ano nga distance? That is 2. Is equal to... Oh, di naman nga triangle. 0.6 is to 3. So this is 0.6 is to 3. So your x will be... I think that would be 0.4. Just to be sure, let me try to go on. Times 2. 0.4. This is 0.4. Okay, so in it is 0.4. Kudain, lutang kudain. This is 0.4. Negative because adi obus. Okay. Yan. Muna na kita influence line. Amo na dito ang influence line. So, kung a-answer nato ng question, if this is the question, okay, ha? Now, diin man nato ng ibutang in if you are to find for the maximum at point D. If this is the load traversing the beam. Siyempre, kita ko nyo, kung na pinakadako, o di man pinakadako, 0.6. Di already ibutang. Dito niyo ibubutang an load. And that is 10. So your shear at point D, the maximum shear at point D is equal to 10 multiplied by 0.6 and that is 6. This is the maximum shear. Okay? How about... Okay. How about if... Okay, I think you get my point na. Kung diin natin ibubutang para magkamayadan yung maximum. Okay? Meron pa kasi isa na i-discuss and moment naman. The influence line for the moment. Okay, so that's how you do it, ah. Okay, hindi kita hit moment. Maida.
May da, kita ikaw. Maida.
So ikaw may da ka. Pati ada inspector rin, may da ka.
Inspector ito, may da ito.
O, dali kita hit koan. Hit, moment. Okay, jadi kita. Sige lang, Roy man lo ako.
Wow,
Roy. Ito naman ni Madam. Okay, jadi kita ha. Jadi kita hit ko ah. This is A. This is B. At ano yung consider midspan na nai para masayo lo. Midspan. Okay, and this is say 2 meters tapos 2 meters para masayin na talaga. Okay, so ginawa natin ang influence line para han moment naman at point C. So paano man? Oh, syempre magbubutang pala ilahin ko ang load 1 unit load tapos adilian ko ang reaction. Let's use red and then reaction. This is 1. Pagka dilili, parang buti ay may manipuun. Okay, and then, 1 in, tapos may lagyap dili, 1, 0. Okay, so, magpas na yung cutting plane dila, tapos adian moment, so, kaya manit moment. Yeah, this is the moment. Tapos, an imo moment. An imo moment is equal to 1 times this distance kasi is 2, di ba? 1 times 2, tapos 1 times 2 para mag-opposite man. Ako, 1 times 2 minus 1 times 2. 0, an imo moment. Okay? So, this tells you that if the load is at point A, the moment at point C is 0. Again, ha? If the unit load is at point A, the moment at point C is equal to 0. Hindi naman kita another. Ibabalik natin ang load. Kali kita. This is point C, A, B. Kali natin ang load naman. Kali kita. Tapos, this is 2 meters, 2 meters. Tapos, pukuhaan mo ang reaction dili. This is, pero ba ang point? Unit load man ano? So, this is 0.5. And this is 0.5. Okay. Tapos, magpapasa yung cutting plane dila. Okay. If you can still remember, di ba na kung kita kanginaan, just to the left of C, iba it is shear, just to the right of just to the right of C is iba niya shear. Pero din yung hit moment, bisang pwede mag just to the left, just to the right, pareho lang ako ito hit moment. Because the behavior of the moment diagram versus the behavior of the shear diagram, medyo mag-iba yung era behavior. It's shear kasi para may dahil na po. Na jump. Charot. Okay, so for this case, okay, added here yung moment. So God, this is your moment. So your moment is equal to, adin man ang force, 0.5 multiplied by 2. This is equal to 1. What na 1 ang imo moment? Okay? 1 ang imo moment if the shear, 1 ang imo moment at point C, if the load pala, then at the shear, if the load is at point C. So amo na iya na, kunhain ang imo load, aad to dito yung maximum unit. Moment. Okay? Kung hain ang imo load, aadto dito ang maximum moment. Okay? And of course, yung mga nga dito ang imo load, ang imo moment, mabak to zero naman ito. Pwede ko na ito solve. So, if we draw the moment diagram, masukal ito niya. Not the moment diagram, the influence line for the moment diagram at point C. Masugal ito niya. This is point C, A, B. Para masugal. Ano
mo yun? Glads.
Yeah. And this distance is 1.
Exercise.
Yan. Oh, I don't know. That's the influence line for the moment at point C. Okay. Pero may nakita kuan, mas masa yun pag himuit influence line. Nasugad naman ito. Okay, influence line naman, iba naman it pag analyze ba. Diba kung kanina and you shear. Diba, kung panangitan this is the beam, mag-share nga rin din at this point, parang makuan, mauutod, masugad. Tapos kung moment nga, diba, bending moment, nagbe-bend ito niya, magbe-bend until such time mautod. Diba, magbe-bend, tapos mautod. So kung dila, kita, when you look at here, kung iyo kita ang didian, influence line, parang it's as if nagbentas na utod. Na-utod din. That's why iya itsura parang nasugnan. So we will use that koan, that principle in finding for the, in drawing, in constructing the influence line. Sorry, let's have another example. The same example, this is 2 meters, 2 meters, and this is A, this is C. Ipapabiling natin ang, ipapakonstruct an influence line for the moment at point C. So, masugad. Okay. Kung diri kita maggamitan kangina, ang conventional koan, maaram kita nga masugad iti itsura. Diba? Kaya nagbe-bend man niya, nagbe-bend. Tapos, parang makuha niya, ano ko ba na, di ko ba na i-explain? Mas nagbe-bend hiya, anto sa sima utod. So, ano yung itsura, magiging sugadini. Kung sugadini taton weight pag solve, di kita maaram kung pera yung nga distance. Let's name that y. Di kita maaram. Pero, this theta here, and this is alpha, for example. Di kita maaram. Pero, wait lang ha, let me check. Ah, okay. I remember na. So, okay. Dili kita maaram yung distance. And in fact, amit aton gin bibiling, di ba? Take note, didian aton kuan, na bilingan naton, ngayon yung distance is 0, is 1. Okay? Using this kuan, another way of solving, nasugan. May natin theta din, may natin alpha. Okay, dili kita maaram yung distance, but we know that tangent bye.
Exercise 2.4 announcement. Exercise 2.4.
Go. Oh. But we know that tangent theta plus tangent alpha is equal to 1.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Ha? Oh, ginulat ko pa kasi ang pag-send. Para ka man mag-send. I-chan-chan ah, dog. Inyak lang ko na hiya. Oo. So, ina, tangent theta plus tangent alpha is equal to 1. So, tangent theta is equal to y over, pero nga distance, 2, di ba? Ada man, 2. Y over 2, tangent is opposite over adjacent. This is y over 2 gihap. This is equal to 1. Solving for the value of y, that is pera ba? Multiply the both equation by 2. So this is y plus y. Multiply both equation by 2. This is 2. 2y is equal to 2. Your y is equal to 1. Yan. That's why. And imo y din is 1. Which is actually correct. Diba? Didi. Y is equal to 1. Okay, that's how you solve. Oh, another example. Another example lang ha. Okay. So, guys, another example. Let us have another example. For example, we have a beam. Tapos, adi naman, nga point C. This is point C. Say, for example, this is 3 and this is 1. Anang litan. So, di it surah ito, it imo influence line na. So, God. Yan. Oops. Yan. Dito kita maaram hindi nga distance. So let's name it y. Pero may nakita di theta. May nakita di alpha. Oh, but we know nga tangent theta plus tangent alpha is equal to 1. Tangent theta, that is y over 3. Hindi ha? Opposite over adjacent. 3 man ini. Ini. Plus y over 1. This is equal to 1. So multiplying both sides of the equation by 3, this is y plus 3y is equal to 3. So this is 4y, this is equal to 3. So your y is equal to 3/4. And that is 0.75. How about y? This is 0.75. Okay? So that's how you construct the moment, the influence line for the moment. Okay, same lang ako. Kung may the overhang didi, kung may the overhang didi, uy, kung ala ini, sugal lang adi. Ako, kung pa nakita may overhang ba? O kung may the overhang didi, extend la ini, tapos, yan. Kung may the overhang. Okay, anyways. Okay, so let's use this example to answer some of the questions. Pananglitan, let me erase this one, ha? Ay, sus! Na-erase, good man. Okay, basta maram kita ito y, that is 0.75, 3 fourths. Kalikula di diit 3 fourths. Ano? Ano, madam? Tapos? Okay, i-risk ko lang ini. Binabati pagod ka, wait. Naku, sige lang, Dere. Dere, binabati. Okay, pananglita may da kita. Oh shit, parisyo yan na. It's so gading. May pagbibiling it maximum moment. Kung may da kita load nga, for example, so god, say, 1 meters, 1 meters? Ano ba yan? Magnitude. Ikita, 2 newton. Para, kwa naman. Tapos 2 newton. Tapos, the distance is, say for example, 1 meter. Yan. Asya it masaklap. Because, the moment kasi is, tanan man positive and moment. Okay. You might think nga, an usa didi, 2 newton, tas an usa didi, 2 newton. Diba? Kay ano, kay maximum didi, masaring ka, sir, kay maximum didi, kasi pwede kasi gyap mag-maximum if ano ba yan? Pwede kasi ka mag-maximum gihap kung aadididian an load 2 newton tapos an 2 newton magara dida somewhere here parang ginbabalance mo light ko an ginbabalance mo it ano. Oh, diri. Wait lang. Sayop. Sayop. Take two. Tama. Kung sugat nga yung itload, atawag ba yun, duduha nga load, nga kuan niya nga, concentrated load, tama. It maximum moment ito niya kung di niya mo ibubutang ang usa tapos di niya mo ibubutang ang usa. Kung magpareho. Ako ha? Kung pananglitan this is 2, tas pananglitan this is for example lang ha, say for example 82 ano ba yun? Asya na? Ano ba yun? Ano bang iniisip ko? Asya na? Tama. Aani din hi. Tapos ano sa naman adi didi. Didi ka mapilihan ko an mas dako. 'Di ba? Kay mas step man didian ko ano niya an iya slope. So dito 2 newton and this is 2 newton. So what you need to find lang is this distance. Yan. Okay, so to answer the question, the maximum moment will be that is of course, we have to solve for this one, Lanay. Let's name this y. Adi nga y. Warain hini nga. Y. Kaya nabilingan naman yung naton. Ano ba yan? Yan. O, adi naman naton y. Okay, so for the value of y is to pero ba yung nga distance? Ini. Di kong didi nga da. That is, take note from here to here is 3, tas ini nga distance is 1, so 2. Y is to 2 is equal to 3 fourth is to 3. Yan, makancel out ang 3. And, mumultiply by 2, y is 1 half. Y is 1 half. Yan. So, this is 1 half. Okay, erase ko lang. Okay, let me erase again. Okay, wala ka tayo space. Basta 1 half itong task. Adi 3 fourth. Adi 3 fourth. Adi 1 half. So, masasolve na natin ang maximum moment. So, the maximum moment
moment is equal to, adila na, 2 newton multiplied by 1/2 plus 2 newton multiplied by 3/4. So your moment is equal to, this is 1 plus 1.5. Yes, 1.5. And your moment, therefore, is equal to 2.5. This is newton meter. What are the minimum moment? That is the maximum moment at point C if we have this type of load. Okay. And akong ginyayakan kanina, okay ha? If this is the type of load, concentrated load, tapos duduha, tapos they are separated by a certain distance. Okay, so that's how you solve it. Okay? How about kung uniformly distributed load naman? Let me erase, i-erase ko. I'm just merely showing you how to solve. It mga technique, it mga usually naging papakian na didahit kuan. Oh, board exam or ha mga kuang kuan, ha mga quiz, ha aton quiz in the future.
Dapat after quiz na.
It ano?
After quiz may re-revealan mga strategy. Para yan na mag-korilanero.
sige lang. Okay. For example, may kita uniform distributed load. So, God. Kasi dyan ha, dere natatadong taakon line. Nagbubaliko-baliko. Dere straight.
Sana all straight.
Okay. So, palangitan ang load natin is 5 kilonewton per meter. Ang litan lang ha. So, ganditon. Okay, so this 3/4, ikali ko lang din eh. Basta 3/4 ito niya. Okay. Kung sugat nga ni ini, tas ang distance niya, for example, is 1 meter. Okay. You cannot put this ini nga load, you cannot put it like this, parang hindi niya mabubutang. Diba? That's not how you do it. You cannot also put it right here. Okay? The best thing to do is to put it dida. Kay aan din hi it pinaka maximum nga area. Diba? Mas dako yung area kontra mas dako ato nga area kontra kon didi nga area tingin ko consider. Okay, sana naintindihan niyo. If you have questions, please ask questions. Bangin lamay da niyo pakiana. Okay. So if that's the case, okay, dito na itong ibubutang. Okay, basta maaram kita, the distance in yung distance is 1 meter. So, kumbaga, i-project natin 1 meter. Pero, kumbaga, atong i-zoom out. Diri kita maaram kung ano ini nga distance. Ini. Di kita maaram from C, di kita maaram nga D. Tapos di kan di dahil sige, di kita maaram nga da. Di da. Amo it aton bibilingon. So, paano natin gin bibiling iton? Di da naman ni gamitan it mga kuha. mga your knowledge in mathematics. Paano ba iton magkakamiada? Masugad. Niya nga lang. Lock.
Hoy, na-delete ko 'yung mga other labeling area.
Distance ng to, distance ng.
Wala ka ani.
Niya, nangalimot ako ng Masarap na nung duman, may dito ng gin set to 0.
Mga calculator ba 'yan?
Oo, calculator techniques.
Linear mode rito. Kati mo ginpa-find?
Ang distance, ini nga distance. Ang ginpa-find natin din ni nga distance. Tapos din nga distance. Maram na kita nga 1 meter. Pero di kita maaram compare ini nga from point C nga dididihan left.
from point C to the left. Para kasi mabilingan natin ini nga height. Para mabilingan natin ang height diyan side-side, kailangan lang natin ang distance. Ini nga distance lang ay. Before natin mabilingan ang ini.
Kailangan... Oh, okay, pwede din. Ani mo lang maram,
1 meter, tikan din hi. Ngayon nga di nga point. I think, gin-equate ini. Ini, ngayon nga di. Kailin ko gin-equate add to. Tama, gin-equate add to. So, God. This is y sub 1, ini nga distance. Let's use another one.
Another color.
Ini y sub 1. Makatulman tako ano. Excuse me.
Walang na lang mag-yellow and red type. Ang kanan. Organic chemistry.
Char! Tapos, ini. Nakakita ba yung green?
Oo.
Nakakita. So, this is Y sub 2. Ini naman, ha? So, nayakan. Magkakamay ang adalara within maximum kuan. Maximum iya moment. If your Y sub 1 and y sub 2 are equal. Oo, madam. Oo. So, isusolve natin it y sub 1. Y sub 1 na anay ha, using the koan, the Riesian proportion. Y sub 1 nga ni, edi nga triangle dati gagamitin. Ini nga triangle. Okay, tapos, that triangle and this triangle. Similar triangle. Go. So, we have y sub 1 over... That is, di naman kita kasi maaram, di ba? Okay, ha? Let's denote this as x. And this denote this as 1 minus x. Kaya maaram kita nga distance nga 1. So, this is x. This is 1 minus x. O, ya? This is x. This is 1 minus x. X ini. So, y sub 1 is 2, 3 minus x. Di ba? Ang x man ini. Ang 3 kasi tikan di d. Adi. Takami naman di dx. So, ini nga distance, tikan din hingad to. That is 3 minus x. Okay? Is equal to 3/4. Adi naman, this distance over this distance. And that is 3. So, your y sub 1 is equal to makancel out ini. This is 3 minus x over 4. Yan. Sunod, magsusolve kitahan y sub 2. Let me erase this one. Y sub 2 naman is 2. Pero yung distance? That distance is 1 minus x. 1 minus 1 minus x. 1 minus 1 minus x. Sana nasusundan. Kasi, tikan din hi, nga di, this is 1. Tapos, ini naman nga distance, araba, 1 minus x. So, ini, this is 1 minus 1 minus x. Kaya, amit hiya. Okay? Let me erase again.
Ako, itakkan yung second year nga subject.
Yan. This is equal to 3/4 is 2, 1. So, simplifying this. Oh, kaya y squared. That is y sub 2, ha? Di written y squared. Y sub 2. Sub 2. Yan. And natin y sub 2 is equal to x. This is 3x over 4, I think, makancel out man, tapos i-multiply, of course, multiply. This is x man, when you simplify. 1 minus 1 is 0, negative times negative x, that is positive x, tapos i-multiply nga diha 3/4, magiging 3x over 4. So, that is y squared. Then, when you equate ko lang, ha? Y sub 1 is equal to y sub 2. Okay, so we have here 3 minus x over 4 is equal to 3x over 4. Solving for x, we will solve 3 minus X over 4 is equal to Oops. 0.75. That is 0.75. So, ano sa naman nga 1 minus x? That is 0.25. Kay 1 man ang irasam. Okay? Okay. Iradraw ko. Iradraw ko.
Do akay to pa di ba ba
This is pirahan ba ang ex na ako?
Nag-abot na 1 million akong pakasabot ikaw.
So, an ex, 1 minus x. Okay. Sorry, may ako lang yung kilawan. So, this is pero ba ang x? 0.75. This is 0.75. And this is pero ba? 0.25. Okay, take note that this is y sub 1 and this is y sub 2. Okay. So, yan na. Take note, hana ka na dito natin igkukuan an. This is pero ba atin load 5 kilonewton per meter? This is 5 kilonewton per meter. Yan. Okay, so let us solve for y sub 1. This ini nga distance that is 3/4. And y sub 1, meron natin equation ng y sub 1, di ba? Di man, y sub 1. Oh. Y sub 1 is 3 minus x over 4. Y sub 1 is equal to 3 minus x over 4. Yan. So this is equal to 3 minos your x is and natin x kasi diba this is x 1 minus x so an x natin is 0.75 over 4 y sub 1 is equal to pero ba itong niya 3 minus 0.75 divide 4 9 over 16 oh. Yeah, so this is 9 over 16. And y sub 2 naman, this is equal to 3x over 4. And natin x kasi is 0.75. 3 times 0.75 over 4. Y sub 2 is equal to 3 times 75. Damo gapit niya, di ba? 9 over 16.
Oo, damo gap.
Damo gap din ito mga graduates.
Oo, damo gap. Ako, di ba?
Kaya iya nga ni supervisor yan na.
Okay.
Ma-assign niya nga niya bilira.
So, we have here y sub 1, which is 9 over 16, and y sub 2, which is 9 over 16. Hala, parang yung man. O, natural kay. In-equate natin. Ano ba yan? Sorry. Okay. So, okay, dili kita hit ko an. Isosolve na natin an moment. Paano man natin isosolve it moment? Ini, dini nga portion, dili na ako an. Na, excuse, my God, sorry. Okay. Tapos ito yan naman din ni, dili hiya na ano, na fall. So, alilani nga yellow, so your moment is equal to your the 5 kilonewton per meter multiplied by an area niya di. Pero ba ito nga trapezoid, di ba? Trapezoid man niya. So, the area of Excuse me. Wait lang ha. Okay, so this is 1/2 multiplied by kay trapezoid man ini, ya di man trapezoid man ini ini trapezoid ya. Yeah. Okay, so 1/2 base 1 which is 3/4. Oops. 3/4 multiplied by the other base which is 9/16. No. Ano ba 'yan? Mark, dito ka na maaaram with area trapezoid. Plus 9/16. Base 1 plus base 2 multiplied by the distance between the bases which is 0.75. Oh, ikurit din ang hindi na nakaka-memorize it ko an. Formula trapezoid. Plus, okay, alin naman kita dili ha, that is 5 kilonewton per meter multiplied by trapezoid man gihap. Oh, trapezoid gihap. 1/2. Base 1 which is 3/4 plus 9/16 the base 2 multiplied by the distance between them which is 0.25. Yan. Moment is equal to kumbaga nakita siya nga asset. So pagkuan pag magre-resign na siya.
Talaga kung magi-interest talaga siya, malaksi siya mabaro para siguro
ako mas ban. Amo talaga ito. If you are, kumbaga nakikita ka nga asseted o sa nga organization, mahirap ka talaga buhian. So guys, when you are already in your professional years.
Natapos na hera. Bulig-bulig man hera. Amo niya si Ring.
Oo. So kung natrabaho na nga ni kamo, dapat it you presence na feel it company. It you absence, gihap, ma-feel it company. Parang gano'n. Para diri kamo basta-basta ginubuhian it company. Excuse me lang. So the answer is 3.28125. This is in kilonewton meter. Yan. That's the maximum moment. Oh. Ada ha? So amo ito nit pagbibiling hit maximum moment if you are given with that type of problem. Kumbaga uniformly distributed load tas may given nga definite length han kuan han unit load. For our case that is 1 meter. Parang suga dito. So that's how you solve. Okay? Okay, again ha, if you have questions, please ask questions. Okay, next. Okay, didi naman kita kuan. Didi kita hit masay mo la kasi ikuan it trusses. So for example, we have truss. Pareho lang ako ito nga kuan.
Magkakuro sa rin yung latrero. Oo, kay kinagsing ang titrero gihapon.
Pustrero? Yung mga trero?
Trero pa. Trero. Ang kabas niya ako on.
Hindi pa ngayon, nag-graduate pa lang ngayon. Diri man symmetric it akong ka-drawing. Pasensya.
Trero, Frederick.
Trero? Nagpipirin nga rin ako dito pa. Naka-online.
Oo,
yan ang president ang lami. O, din hinaman ikuan. Din hinaman hit trusses na nga nit aton gin ko consider. It aton usually nga gin papahimuan hin ko an hin influence line is the forces on the member. Diba kanina, natong ginhimuan yung influence line is the shear on a point. On a certain point. Yun naman, an internal forces on a member. So for example, let's name this, this A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Yan. So pananglitan na natong ginbibiling member nga ginko-construct an influence line for the internal force of member, say for example BE. BE ha. Okay, ada. So hain iton nga ko aditon ha, adi man iton nga BE. Yan. Okay, the drawing on ta iya influence line. Mo sayon la iton. Masugod la iton niya. Susugod sayon nila. So god. Syempre, imulaan ay kukuanon, imulaan ay magbutang kadidahin kuan in it una ni mo nga bibuhaton ng ubutang kadidahin load unit load lang one. Okay, then you solve for the reactions. Reaction kung ano din da it one ano man it mga reactions natural ano na wait lang ha ikadit habaw dida kung ano dida animo reactions syempre ada dida it one gihap di animo reaction di zero. Yan. Okay, so to solve for the kuan naman for the internal force maggamit kitahin method of suction para madagmit. So gan. Kukat kain cutting pain dida. Tas ang gibibiling nimo is yan hi. Okay, ikukuan nato ni erase ko ha. Wala naman yung gamit nga di erase ko. Hindi
ko
rin madali lang trust, madam. Yan. So an ini nga mga member nga nagkautod mahihimit yung mga forces. Yan. Tapos ini. Tapos ini. Oo. Tapos mga karanan tayo, this is BD. This is BD. Tas ini naman this is ABCDE. BE. Tas ari naman nga ini naman nga force right here it is CE. Ang atong gibibiling is BE. Take note ha. BE an aton ginbibiling. So to do that alam, wala ngayon natin pagbutanghin ko, ano, wala ko magbutanghin mga, drawing ko lang yung how did it.
Gini-encourage mo mga maghimo talaga ng letter, ang regular classes, kaya nagkuhan ni DBTAan, may Dania Memo, na maghimo yung makeup class for, letter and makeup class for regular classes, tapupak ang 3 weeks. Oo. Actually, we're already practicing that makeup class.
Okay, so for example, wala kita mag, wala ko makapagbutang. This distance is 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4 at 3 meters. So 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 12. So 3 meters eh, 3 meters. Say for example, the height is, say, 4 meters. Okay, so this is 4, this is 3. Okay? So yan na, anatong ibibiling? Ibibiling nga tayo ni nga angle. Or bisan diri na. Okay? So, igsasam natin ang moment. We are solving for the value of BE. Okay ha? Summation of forces along vertical is equal to 0. So we have here 1 ngadto baw-baw. Tapos may din natin paubos gihap nga 1 minus 1. Tapos may din na ini nga BE paubos, that is minus BE. BE multiplied by 4 over 5 is equal to 0. 1 minus 1 is 0 man. So, an imo BE is 0. Okay? Ibig sabihin, if the unit, okay, didi kita. If the unit force is at the support, at this point, right here, didi, kung nga didi an imo unit load, ibig sabihin, an imo BE, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Ibig sabihin, ang imo BE, ang iya internal load, internal force is 0. Okay, nakuha natin kasi 0. Okay, tapos, same lang ako kangina, imo naman ililiwat, diba kangina nakadan aton load? Ililiwat mo naman itong nga load, ikakadi mo hiya DD, a point C. Or pwede ha point B. Anyway, diba, ini nga force, ikakadi mo nga DD, it will not change the effect, diba? According to Varignon's theorem. Varignon's theorem states that the effect of a force is equal to rise throughout its line of action. So, kung ano naman ang force ni mo at point C, kung ada dida, okay, kung ada dida ni mo kuan, same lang ha, magpapas ka yung cutting plane nga datas i-isolate mo. Kakaliwa, I will use the same kuan. The same free body diagram. Ha, take note ha, nagpass ka yung cutting plane dida, tapos i-consider ko ang left side of the ano. So, we'll have the here, oops. Kasugad. Tapos may daan mo, BD. Tapos may daan mo, DD, BE. Tapos may daan mo, DD, CE. Tapos, ay, wala pa natin ka-solve ang reaction. Pero at reaction, kung hindi niya ankuan at point C. So, an imo reaction DD, let's use, ano? An imo reaction DD is, pera ba? Summing the moment here, that is RA multiplied by 12 is equal to 1 multiplied by 9. So, your RA is equal to 9 over 12. And that is, pero wait, 9 over 12, 3 over 4. 3 fourth. Yan. So, your RA is 3 fourth. Okay. Let me erase this one. I-erase ko kay wala ko space. Basta maram nakit RA is 3 fourth. So, this is 3 fourth. And of course, an E mo gin apply dito ha point C, di ba? A, B, C. Of course, you have to include the unit load. That is 1. Okay, now you are solving for the value of BC. Same lang nga how, ang atong gagamitin is the summation of forces vertical is equal to 0. So, we have here 3 fourth upward minus 1 kay downward. Tapos an adi? An vertical component han BE. And that is negative because downward man. BE multiplied by 4 over 5. Using this triangle. Ano kasi triangle na sugad? 4, DD 3, tapos this is 5. That is 4 over 5. This is equal to 0. So, solving for the value of BE, this is equal to, let me try to use the calculator. So, we have here, what about 3 over 4. Minus 1. Divided by 4 over 5. That is 5 over 16. Negative 5 over 16. Yan. Negative 5 over 16. Yan. Kaya, ikukwala natin. Underline. 0, tapos nag-negative 5 over 16. Tapos, same lang ahaw, ininga load. Wait lang. Kaya, as, ano ba yan? Tapos, anyan, hinga load. Imo naman nga ako, ibabalhin nga diha, point E. Okay, let us use different color nga kuan. Pwede rin kinikita. Tapos, kanina, di ba? O, kanina ha, naka diha, point A, ang imo unit load. Tapos, ginbalhin mo nga diha, point C. Tapos, yan, ibabalhin mo nga diha, point E. Okay ha, point E. Pagbalhin mo nga point E, unit load man. So, you have to solve for the reaction at point A. Nakadi an imo unit load at point E. Tapos, an imo isosolve naman an unit and reaction at point A. O, paano man? Your reaction at point A will be, ano man iabot nga? Symmetric man. 1/2. 1/2. Ta? An imo reaction is 1/2. We'll use the same koan. We'll use the same free body diagram. So, masok ka dito niya. Okay, ha? Wait lang. So, this is BD. This is BE. And this is CE. Tapos, DD, may dani mo 1/2. That's it. This is ABC. So, for the value of BE, we'll use the summation of forces vertical that is equal to 0. So, you have here upward 1/2 minus and BE multiplied by 4 over 5. This is equal to 0. So, your BE will be 1/2 divided pira ba? 1/2 BE is equal to 1/2 divided by 4/5. So that is your BE therefore is equal to 5/8. 5/8, let me check. 0.5 divided by 4/5. 5/8. This is 5/8. Positive. Okay? Ang BE. Okay, nag-ini nga kita. Imunganin ibalhin nga diha ha point F. Okay, again ha. Kangina na ka diha point A and aton load. Tapos ginbalhin natin ha point C. Kali natin ha point C. Tapos yan na, kali natin ha point E. Nakuha natin an. Pero baan nakuha natin na diha ubus. 5/8 positive. Okay, dire ko na kukuha on di dahil kuan at point G. Okay. Tapos kun kalingarin nato na point ano, ha point how was this? Ha point H E B C D E F G H O H. A point H. Syempre an iya reaction na ada dida. So mag zero gap in DD. An kuan. So okay ha. Pag zero imo nga ni kada ha point H for sure ako mag zero itong dida an ang tawag ito an internal load dito ha BE. Okay. So if you want to draw, you can check it out pero I'm sure zero ito niya. Okay, so to draw the ano kinasugad man adto. So bitap drawing. A, B, C, D. Ayan. So, kung i-drawing natin ang influence line niya, nasa agad itong dida. Kung nakadaan load, di ba, 0 at the support, sure ako, 0. Kung nada it load ha support, 0 itong it internal load ha BE. Tapos, pag kunada ha point C, negative ko ang daw. Pero ba, add to negative 5/8. Ah, negative 5/16. So, add ito here, DD. negative 5 over 16. Tapos pagka diha E, pagka di diha E, ang value niya is, 5 over 8. That is positive 5 over 8. Kaya naman rin ko i-solve. Kaya sure ako, straight line kasi it nga to. Zero DD. Straight line kasi ako. If you want to solve ini nga distance, ratio and proportion na lang. Okay, so amin niya i-influence line. Tas, yan. Amin niya influence line. Four traces. Okay, so, my advice is that it exolve nala and support, for sure kasi kung it imo unit load at it support, zero kasi itun. Okay? It exolve nala and immediately, for example, kung adi nang ginpapa, adi nga BE and ginpapa billing, parang litan adi nga BE. It exolve nala and e-internal force kung an unit load ada hasi, adi nato nakuha, negative 5 over 6. Tapos, kung an e-unit load ada ha e, nakuha nato, makukuha nato is 5 over 8. Tapos, sure naman kita mga straight line naman itong dida. Just connect, connect. Mm-hmm. Okay? So, that's how you do it. Natural, if you want to solve for the koan, for the maximum, maximum internal force at BE, mayroon ka naman, mayroon ka naman influence line. Oh, this influence line works the same way dito han influence line para han shear, han para han movement. Pareho lang nga how itong hiya. Only this time, this is the influence line for the internal force for of a member of a truss. Yan. Sige, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Okay? So, sugod lang nga how itong. Okay? So, ama ito niya is pag-ukuhan ng truss. Ang sunlight truss. Okay. So, if you don't have any questions, okay, I will end my lecture here. If you have any question, please feel free to ask. You may comment or you may message me or any one of us, Ma'am RJ and Ma'am Rina. You can message us via an aton chat or the group chat. Okay? So that's all for today. Para pa ako maghatag han cables. Matitigdaan na naman ko.
Tigdaan niya niran ako.
San ubay ko? San ubay it exam?
Tipo ko nung halalaba ko nung yung solution, tas at the very end, sayup.
Okay.
Dito talaga, it's part 3, it's part.
Okay, that's all for today. Good day and God bless.
Ano tiksam?